Effective Interim Resolution Professional, Mr. Anuj Jain, Executive Chairman, sir, and dear shareholders, good afternoon, everyone. I, S.K. Mata, Company Secretary and Compliance Officer of your company, has joined this meeting from GA House, Vasant Vihar, New Delhi. And I welcome you to this 13th Annual General Meeting of JP Infratech Limited through video conferencing. This is as per requirement of Companies Act, Listing Regulations, and various other circulars issued by Ministry of Corporate Affairs and SEBI. The notice of AGM for conducting the same through video conferencing was sent on 1st December 2020 via electronic mode through Central Depository Services India Limited to all such members whose email IDs were registered with the company and whose email IDs were available with the depositories as on 20th November 2020. The facility to join the meeting through VC is provided to up to 1,000 shareholders of the company on first-come, first-served basis only. Pursuant to the MCA surplus, as the meeting is conducted through VC, hence attendance through proxy is not allowed. I would like to take you through certain important points for joining this meeting through video conferencing. All the members who have joined this meeting are put on mute mode by default to avoid noise and disturbances during the proceeding of this meeting for smooth and seamless conduct of the meeting. As per the requirement of the Companies Act 2013 and SEBI listing regulations, the facility for e-voting at the meeting has been provided by CDSL. Members present in this meeting and who have not voted through remote e-voting, which facility was made available between 21st December 2020, 9 a.m. to 23rd December 2020, 5 p.m. may cast their vote while at the same time watch the proceedings of the meeting. Voting through show of hands is not allowed. Voting facility will remain open throughout the meeting and for further time as may be announced by the chairman of the meeting. The members who were holding shares on cutoff date, that is 13th December 2020, can only cast their vote for the business of the meeting. Since the meeting is through video conferencing and the resolutions mentioned in the notice convening this AGM have already been put to vote through remote e-voting and also voting on the resolutions is available during the meeting, there will be no proposing or seconding for the resolutions. Further, all the documents referred to in the notice of the AGM and statutory registers are available for inspection by members as per process mentioned in the AGM notice. As quorum has that been completed? As per the confirmation from the host of the meeting, quorum for this meeting is present. May I now request Shri Anuj Jain ji, Interim Resolution Professional of the company, to take up further proceeding at the meeting.
Thank you, Shri Mataji. Good afternoon, shareholder. I welcome you all for the annual general meeting of JP Infratech Limited. I am the Interim Resolution Professional appointed by Honorable NCLT Allahabad and reiterated by Honorable Supreme Court of India. Since this is a shareholders meeting, I request the chairman of the board, shareholder, director and chairman, Shri Manoj Gaurji, to please chair the meeting on behalf of the shareholders. And I have very limited role to play as the interim resolution professional, so I pass on the baton to Manojji. Manojji, over to you, sir.
Thank you, Anuji. I am thankful to Shri Anuj Jainji, though designated as interim resolution professional, but has been guiding the fortune of the company now almost in its fourth year since the time he came in August 2017. So I thank him for inviting me to chair this meeting. I have joined this meeting through video conferencing from J House, Vasant Vihar, New Delhi. Good morning to all the shareholders. and all dignitaries who have joined, who are live and participating in this virtual meeting. I welcome you all in the 13th AGM of JP Infotech. As we can see, it is 13th AGM. Number 13 is lucky for some and unlucky for some. But I hope it is lucky for all the shareholders, all the home of JP Infotech, and all the people who have been associated with the company. On account of COVID-19 pandemic, as we all are aware, entire world is passing through this storm of COVID with mixed results. At the same time, with renewed hope, I have nothing to add to what you know already. However, it is also a matter of fact that entire thought process, entire perception, entire priorities have got changed in last about 9 months. We personally speaking, we have to remain thankful to Almighty God that we have a government who is responsive, who is proactive, and our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji has been leading from the front, courageously taking steps. And the fact is that as we end this very eventful 2020, we have more hope than what we had in the month of June when the unlockdown one was commenced. Whatever happened in last 9 months, it is a matter of history, and it will be written and spoken, debated by people for a long, long time to come. However, limiting our discussions to this meeting today to carry forward the responsibility assigned to us, since the requisite quorum is present, I call the meeting into order. Shri Pankaj Mangal ji from Dasutva & Associates, Chartered Accountant, the Assessor Auditor of the company, and Srimati Sunita Mathur, the Secretary Auditor, are also present through video conferencing. Shri Ashok Tyagi ji, Practicing Company Secretary, and Ms. Neha Jain, Practicing Company Secretary, Acting as Scrutinizer and Alternate Scrutinizer respectively, are also present through video conferencing. The scrutinizers have been appointed to scrutinize remote e-voting and e-voting process during this meeting. I welcome them also. Dear shareholders and all dignitaries who are part of this virtual meeting today, with mixed sentiments, I would like to address this forum in the capacity in which Mr. Anuj Jain ji has invited me to chair this meeting. I am conscious that while entire world in general, India in particular, shareholders, home buyers of JP Infotech in very particular, we all have been waiting with unabated breath, not only for the vaccination of COVID, but also for the order of Honorable Supreme Court on the various proceedings pertaining to the fate of JP Infotech. It is again tribute to our legal system, the courage of our honorable, respected judges who held extensive hearing in the Honorable Supreme Court, spanning days and every day spanning hours to hear all sides, give a patient hearing, interjecting at every important point to understand for better clarity, and order reserved since 6th October. As you all know, while I speak to you, the order is still awaited, and we hope and pray that justice will be granted. And this company, JP Infratech, as we all know, the creator of iconic Yamuna Expressway linking Noida to Agra by almost 175 km long concrete expressway. It is not only a concrete expressway, it is not only a milestone in infrastructure as its logo says, but it was a fulfillment of the vision of Government of UP by the founder of the JP Group, Respect Jay Prakash Ji, and it also laid the foundation for multiple expressways which have since taken off in the state of UP. We all know Agra to Lucknow became a reality. We all know the outer ring road at Agra is a reality. And I'm sure many of you know the expressway from Lucknow to Balia under name and title Purvanchal Expressway is also under implementation. So in fact, the expressway which was envisaged in year 2000 after many failed attempts when JP Group was entrusted this responsibility in 2003 and again the project stalled by the policymakers of UP for 2 years and then the project restarted in 2007, completed in 2012, today is in the forefront as a creator of the expressway network of state of UP. It is also a matter of fact that with great satisfaction, India also notes, and when I say India, I mean entire India, that soon Delhi will have a second international airport, just like other developed nations. Heathrow has Gatwick, New York has Newark, so Delhi Airport will have Jewar Airport as its sister airport. And this is again possible because Yamuna Expressway is a reality. The vision and the perfection with which the expressway was made was truly reflected and advertised to the world when Indian Air Force chose to land a fighter aircraft on one stretch. And that made the beginning of a clause that every new expressway in the country will have at least 5 km dedicated in a manner that any time an aircraft can land in emergency. And the point to be noted here is that when we built the Yamuna Expressway, we built as if we are making a road, but road good enough to withstand a aircraft landing. And that today has become a protocol for new expressways in the country. We are grateful to God that we got this opportunity to build that expressway. And also, we got the opportunity to make iconic development at Fishtown, Noida. The business model of the company was not flawed. Again, a debate will remain why the company went into IBC, whether IBC was a solution, but it is not here to debate. But point to be noted here is that in the year 1920, we had a traffic which had an impact of -2% because of the deep lockdown which got initiated in March. Otherwise, the financial company have remained strong. In fact, the gross revenue for the year FY20 was 1587 crores against the 1292 crores for FY19. It is also a matter of great satisfaction and also evidence of robustness of the company's asset base that in spite of the fact that company is its fourth year finding a solution under IBC with intervention on the Supreme Court and also having been subjected to four changes in the law. The net worth of the company, which was in July 17, 5,036 crores, has been still a healthy net worth of 3,200 crores as of March of 2020. I am also like to share with the shareholders that since Shri Anuj Jainji has taken the seat and has been overseeing the operation of the company with his reasoning, compassion and sense of purpose which he displayed between September 2017 to December 2019, 7,700 homes were completed and delivered. It is an irony of it that in spite of the fact that Jal has remained as a contractor, Jal as a responsible shareholder of JP Infratech has continued to cooperate with the IRP. IRP wanted to complete the homes as per the plan which he had followed from September 2017. But due to one reason or the another, beyond the control of IRP, and of course beyond the control of Jal, the homes from January 2020 could not be, completion could not be taken up, and the progress almost became to naught. And the pandemic had its own impact on the entire thing in during last about 8 months. Well, with this, I can only say that with mixed sense, that after being part of this organization for all these years, after being part of the team of my father, respected Godsar, in bringing shape to this iconic Yamuna Expressway, there it might be that this is a farewell meeting for me. However, I remain sanguine that just like Sher Shah Suri's name remains in our history, remains in the minds of generation for building the Grand Trunk Road of India, I am sure people will remember that a visionary step was taken by a man, an ordinary man, who rose to do extraordinary infrastructure things for the country. We have taken the brunt of the evolving IBC system in the country. I am sure with the blessing of God, with the wisdom of policy makers, with the justness of our judiciary, fair and just judgment would come and homes will be made, given to all the home buyers, and company will continue to inspire entrepreneurship in the country, because such companies which can alter the entire landscape, one has to travel from Noida to Agra to understand what is the meaning of changing a landscape. What is the meaning? It will again undergo a change after 5 years when the JVA report is commissioned. So I am grateful to God that I am part of this company. I am proud that I have been serving this company, and I am extremely thankful to a very wise and very pragmatic and a man of integrity, Mr. Anuj Jain, who has allowed us to complete whatever we could do. And I along with the team continue to cooperate with him. And at this moment, I can only thank him again and pray for justice and pray for good health of all in New Year. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Mataji, if you can read the auditor's report.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. The reports of the statutory auditors and secretarial auditors of the company form part of annual report, which has been already circulated to the members. As per request, may I read only the first and last para from the auditor's report for the financial year 2019-20, which is on page number 56 and page number 99 of annual report, and the rest be taken as read.
Now, my point?
This is report on the standalone financial statements. We have audited the accompanying standalone financial statement of JP Infratech Limited, the company, which comprised the balance sheet as at March 31st, 2020, the statement of profit and loss, including other comprehensive income, the statement of changes in equity, and the statement of cash flows for the year ended on that day, and a summary at significant accounting policies and other explanatory information, herein after referred to as the standalone financial statement. The last para reads as required by the companies, auditor's report order 2016, the order issued by the central government of India in terms of subsection 11 of section 143 of the Act, we give in Annex B a statement on the matter specified in para 3 and 4 of the order. This report has been given by Messrs. Das Gupta and Associate Chartered Accountant, who are statutory auditors of the company. Full standalone auditor's report is available from page number 56 to 61 and consolidated auditor's report from page number 99 to 103. The secretarial auditor's report in the form of MR3 is available from page number 22 to 24 of the annual report, and the management's comment on the observations are given in the report to the shareholders at page number 13 and 14. May I now request Chairman sir to kindly take up the agenda of the meeting for members' approval.
Thank you, Company Secretary, Mr. Mata. Notice convening AGM, report to shareholders, auditor's report, financial statements, including consolidated financial statement having already been circulated to members with the permission of member present, are taken as read. I now take up the agenda item as per the notice circulated to members and explain objectives and implications of each of the items as included in the notice. Item number one is ordinary business. To receive, consider and adopt the audited statements and consolidated financial statement of the company for the financial year ended on March 31, 2020, together with the report, auditors and doctors and directors thereon, ordinary resolution. It is, in fact, a statutory requirement as per Section 129 and 134 of Company 130.
Next item.
So, it is e-voting?
This has been through e-voting as well as voting going on right now.
Item number two is a special business. To consider, discuss and approve the ratification of proposed remuneration payable to cost auditor Messrs. Jatin Sharma and Company, cost accountant financial year 2020-21 pursuant to provisions of section 148(3) and all other applicable provisions, if any, of the Companies Act 2013 and rules made there under ordinary resolution. It is a statutory requirement to ratify the proposed remuneration of ₹4,50,000 of cost auditors, which is reasonable and is same as was in last year, without inflation. We thank cost auditor to absorb the inflation and continue to work for the company. In line with the prevailing SEBI and MC circulars, members have provided the facility of e-voting during the AGM. Therefore, the members are requested to cast their votes in respect of each of the aforesaid resolutions. Now, the learned company secretary has forwarded to me that some shareholders have raised certain queries and questions which are in front of me. Am I right? Any other question which might have come as part of the virtual hearing can also be forwarded to me.
Yes. So questions have already been logged. Pehle aa gaye.
Ji.
So we can start.
For I am Well, this is a question which is in the mind and on lips of everyone about the future prospects of the company. Well, I can with my limited ability, but with conviction and faith in Almighty, say that as a shareholder, each shareholder, after enduring pain of last 3.5 years of the stock being so undervalued, must take satisfaction that in spite of the fourth year of the proceeding under the company has been undergoing under IBC, in spite of the fact the company under scrutiny and surveillance of the various authorities, including the Honorable Supreme Court, it has been run by an extremely pragmatic and dedicated professional, designated IRP, and its net worth remains 200. It has a cash balance in excess of 150 crores as of December, as of November rather.
180 crores.
And its turnover, it has a 4,000 acre land unencumbered, which as per the circle rate of the state of government of UP is worth at least 15,000 crores. With toll rights remaining for 28 years, which will fetch at least 70,000 crores, and road and the land for development is still unencumbered 4,000 acres, means the company is among the richest in terms of asset base. It is again an irony of fate that a company of this type can ever undergo an IBC proceeding. It is also a matter of fact that a company, there is something which is wrong to start with when IBC is ticked in, that four times the law has been changed for voting and making that status of home buyers at par with lenders or greater than lenders. So, therefore, I will not like to enter this debate. I only say the companies which prospects are very bright. We all await the decision of the Supreme Court, and we pray that a fair and just decision comes in the interest of each stakeholder, including bankers, home buyers, shareholders, and employees. What is there in the real plan for shareholders? Well, As per the revision plan which was put to vote, and same revision plan earlier were rejected, but because of the voting pattern having been modified by the government, it got approved. So the non-promoter shareholder shall be paid an exit price aggregating to rupees 1 crore. And thereafter their shareholding will be extinguished. So this is as in the revision plan which was submitted by NBCC, and definitely it is not in the interest of normal shareholders, and that is why some shareholders went to the Supreme Court craving for justice. Question number 3. What steps are taken by management to minimize impact and effect on business and activity of company in the aftermath of COVID-19? Well, the toll revenue from the expressway has got reduced for the first 4 months from March to July. But after that, it is almost at par. Of course, growth is not there, but almost 90% of pre-COVID.
More than that last year, 1.56.
Fine. So it is, and added to that is operationalization of Eastern Peripheral Expressway. That has added to the traffic. So things are only better on the toll front. As far as questions citing whether directors could cut their remuneration sitting fee, I can tell you that no director has been getting any money from the company, because after the IBC proceedings ticked in August 17, the board was suspended, and it's only whatever fees company is incurring money is incurring expenditure on account of fees to legal luminaries. On the COVID impact, there is no job and salary cut due to COVID because company could afford and company was waiting whether as and when restrictions will be removed, how work will be taken up.
Salaries are all paid on time.
Sorry?
Salaries are all paid on time.
They're paid on time. Always. Salaries paid on time. That's why. Well, the question is what RP has done to take the company out from NCLT. Well, RP has a limited brief. And RP, IRP, as we know in this case, has been taking all whatever he could do to come to invite express of interest, discuss the plans in the committee of creditors, and put the plan on voting. And he has fulfilled all the duties which are prescribed under the IBC code. It is also a matter of fact that plan of resolution applicant was with certain modifications cleared by NCLT because the concessions sought by the resolution applicant were contrary to the IBC code. So certain modifications were indicated by the NCLT. However, Honorable Supreme Court got everything to itself from the NCLAT so that they could expedite after hearing various stakeholders. So we all await that decision and there is nothing which has been pending with IRP in dissolving the company. As far as tax disputes are concerned, company under IBC code is working as per the brief company can do. So the final outcome of what will happen on income tax, etc., we will see as and when the plan is approved by Honorable Court. Another last question is, expense of last year's physical year AGM, including printing and postal notice and annual report and travelling of directors for AGM, etc. The total expenditure was 18.72 lakhs and no amount was spent on travelling directors for AGM last year. This year AGM, because it is virtual AGM, the spend is likely to be around 6 lakhs.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mataji.
Please.
We can take one or two.
Yes.
We request if questions are not repeated.
Yes.
So kindly do speak.
Mr. Ajay Kumar Jain.
Unko unmute karenge kaise?
Can you please connect to Mr. Ajay Kumar Jain?
Namaskar, sir. Delhi se Jain shareholder bol raha hun. Pehle Nuji ko namaskar aur hamare adhyaksh Ajay ko namaskar.
Namaskar.
Ji aur ko tha clear ho gaya lekin main Manoj ji को आगे दी कि बताने के लिए कंपनी का फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्टस वो उन्होंने बिल्कुल पॉइंट पॉइंट बिल्कुल क्लियर कर दिया जाए किसी भी बंदिशें थी या कुछ भी, लेकिन आज भी उन्होंने एक एक बात बिल्कुल क्लियर करी. ये हमारे मनोज जी की जो पर्सनैलिटी है उसको दर्शाता है कि वो आज इतने भी विषम परिस्थितियों में भी कंपनी के बारे को में अच्छा सोच रहे हैं, कंपनी को आगे बढ़ाने के बारे में सोच रहे हैं. और साथ में अनुज जी का देखा ही और भविष्य में कंपनी अपने इन सब कानूनी विषयों से हटकर कंपनी दोबारा बाहर आएगी और कंपनी दोबारा उसी पहुंचेगी. मनोज जी ने अभी मीटिंग चालू होने में कहा था कि 13 नंबर शायद कंपनी के लिए अनलक्की या लक्की. अरे मनोज जी पार्टी का नेतृत्व कुशलता ही इतनी अच्छी है, कोई अनलकी चीज भी लकी बन जाती है। मनोज जी का हाथ तो वो पत्थर है, वो कहाँ भी लगाता है। तेरा नंबर तो क्या था, कोई सा भी नंबर हो कभी जीवन में आपका अनलकी नहीं होता, सब आते हैं। अब जब सूर्य के आगे ग्रहण लग जाता है तो वो कोई कहता है कि लकी है। और आपके साथ तो बाबू जी का हाथ कृपा का इतना अच्छा है कि कभी कुछ होगा नहीं। और साथ में हमारे अनुज जी बैठे हैं, वो किसी के लिए अच्छे के लिए ही सारे अपनी परामर्श देंगे और इससे कंपनी आगे बढ़ेगी। कभी भी जीवन में तो आपको शुरू से देखते आ रहे हैं मनोज जी, आपकी कंपनी अच्छी है। और आपने अभी प्रीवियस 2 महीने पहले अपनी पेरेंट कंपनी के बारे में जो कहा था, उसको शेयर बाजार ने इतना हर्ष के साथ लिया, शेयर का प्राइस ही डबल हो गया। और तो हमें तो आपके ऊपर हमेशा, और आपको आपसे कितना भी ऐसा भी रहा, लेकिन मैंने इस मौके को छोड़ने का कोई अवसर नहीं गंवाना था कि मैं मनोज जी के दर्शन ना कर पाऊँ और उनकी विचारों को ना सुन पाऊँ। इसके लिए मैं आपका धन्यवाद हूँ सबसे। और से इस सब माध्यम में हमारे कंपनी सेक्रेटरी साहब माटर साहब है, उनका बड़ा योगदान रहा। मैंने उनको फोन किया तो उन्होंने कहा नहीं नहीं, मैंने कहा सर कुछ कंपनी में कहने की बात करें तो हमारे मनोज जी हैं, उनके सामने अपना पक्ष रखिए, वो पूरा सुनेंगे। और उन्होंने मुझे ये मौका दिया और मैं तो यही कहूँगा कंपनी के सारे कष्टों को खत्म कर दे और 2021 है ना, दोबारा कंपनी का उच्चती हो बजाए। जब जिस प्रकार हम है ना कंपनी के द्वारा निर्मित टोल पे जाते हैं यमुना एक्सप्रेस हाईवे पे, वो उसी तरह कंपनी की दोबारा कीर्ति आगे फैले। मनोज जी को नमस्कार और अनुज जी को नमस्कार। नमस्कार सर,
थैंक यू सो मच। आपको प्रणाम करता हूँ, धन्यवाद करता हूँ और भगवान से प्रार्थना करता हूँ 2021 सबके लिए शुभ हो। और आपके शब्दों में और आपकी शुभकामनाओं में बहुत ताकत भी है और बहुत उत्साह से भरी आपने हमारे लिए बात कही है, आदरणीय गौर साहब के लिए बात कही है। बस मैं यही ईश्वर से प्रार्थना करूंगा कि ये विश्वास बना रहे और भगवान हमको मौका दे कि आपका विश्वास को हम और मजबूत कर पाए। धन्यवाद।
सेकेंड स्पीकर इज मिस्टर संतोष कुमार सर्राफ। कैन यू प्लीज कनेक्ट मिस्टर संतोष कुमार सर्राफ?
हाँ जी, नमस्कार। एक मिनट सर, सर वीडियो देंगे? दे दिए सर। आज की मीटिंग के चेयरमैन साहब और हमारे आरपी साहब, आप सभी को मेरा नमस्कार सर। मैं संतोष कुमार सर्राफ कलकत्ता से बोल रहा हूँ सर। ये वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंस मीटिंग के कारण आज मुझे मौका मिला है, पता नहीं नेक्स्ट टाइम में क्या होगा, किसी को पता नहीं है। और मनोज जी आप बोल रहे हैं आपकी फेयरवेल मीटिंग है, तो भगवान करे ऐसा ना हो, आपकी फेयरवेल मीटिंग ना हो, कंपनी जल्दी से रिवाइवर कर जाए। हो सकता है NBCC में मर्ज हो या कोई भी टेक ओवर करे तो स्टेटस आपका बदल सकता है। लेकिन मैं उनसे यही प्रार्थना करूंगा कि आप जैसे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को कम से कम अपने डायरेक्टर में जरूर रखे हुए, जिससे कंपनी को फ्यूचर में उनकी नॉलेज का, जो इतने साल की नॉलेज उसका मतलब ज्ञान प्राप्त होगा और हमारी कंपनी प्राप्त होगी सर। और सर मैं आप लोग सबके स्वास्थ्य की कामना करता हूँ। आशा करता हूँ इस कोविड के अंदर में अपने जितने भी स्टाफ हैं और जितने भी मतलब है मैनेजर स्टाफ जो भी है या जो भी स्टेक होल्डर है, जो भी आपके मतलब क्लाइंट है जिन्होंने अपने को ऑर्डर दिया है, वह सब स्वस्थ होगी, उनकी फैमिली स्वस्थ होगी। और सर मैं एक चीज कहूंगा कि मुझे ऑब्जेक्शन, आप बुरा नहीं मानिएगा, ये मेरे व्यू है, हो सकता है आपको पसंद नहीं आया। आपने जेपी का नाम जयप्रकाश से जोड़ा सर, तो जयप्रकाश जी तो मालूम काफी रिस्पेक्टेड पर्सन थे। ये जेपी ग्रुप में हमने दो कंपनी बनाया, दोनों कंपनी में हम डूब गए सर। तो मैं चाहूंगा कि मतलब जयप्रकाश जी बोलो, जयप्रकाश जी मत जेपी बोलने से अच्छा रहेगा कि जयप्रकाश जी हमारे बहुत बड़े स्ट्रगल फाइटर थे, जनता को उन्होंने जनता सरकार ने क्या की सर, तो मुझे अच्छा लगेगा जेपी बोले, मुझे दुख नहीं है। तो जयप्रकाश के लिए जो आपने डिटेल में नाम बोला उसके लिए मेरा सब ऑब्जेक्शन है, मेरे को क्षमा करिएगा, मैं आपकी बात से सहमत नहीं हूँ सर। तो जेपी है और जयप्रकाश में डिफरेंस है, जेपी जेपी है, जयप्रकाश जयप्रकाश जी है। पूरा नाम बोले तो जयप्रकाश जी से होता है, जो हमारे लीडर थे सर जो गुजर गए 1977 के आसपास सर। तो मैं क्षमा चाहूंगा सर, मैं आपकी बात से मत नहीं, अब आपके विचार जो भी हो सर। और सर ये मैं दूसरा ये कहूंगा सर, NBCC के साथ में जब मर्ज होगी तो स्मॉल, आपने बताया लेकिन मेरे को सुनने में क्लियर नहीं हुआ, स्मॉल जो शेयर होल्डर है जिनके 100-200 शेयर है उनका स्टेटस क्या होता है? आपने 1 करोड़ कुछ बताया लेकिन क्लियर चीज समझ नहीं आती, एक बार दोबारा अगर क्लियर करते हैं तो बहुत अच्छा होगा सर। और ज्यादा समय मैं आपसे नहीं लूंगा सर, मैं फिर आप लोग के स्वास्थ्य की कामना करता हूँ, जितने भी डायरेक्टर उनके स्वास्थ्य की कामना करता हूँ। और अगर हम रहेंगे सर शेयर होल्डर तो अगले साल जो भी मुलाकात होगी सर। हाँ सर दो मनोज जी आप चिंता मत की, आपकी फेयरवेल मीटिंग नहीं है, मैं फिर आपको आपकी फेयरवेल मीटिंग नहीं है आप भूल जाइए, आपने ये वर्ड है नहीं है। और अनुज जी भी अच्छे आदमी है और मैं माता जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ, उन्होंने मुझे पर्सनल फोन किया, मुझसे बात की, कभी बात तो वे भी बहुत अच्छे आदमी सर। धन्यवाद सर, एक बार कंपनी के अच्छे स्वास्थ्य की कामना करता हूँ, आप लोग के अच्छे स्वास्थ्य की कामना करता हूँ और भगवान से प्रार्थना करता हूँ जल्दी जल्दी कंपनी रिवाइवल हो जाए सर। और सर आने वाले कल क्रिसमस की शुभकामना देता हूँ और नए दिन जो नया उसके भी शुभकाम करता हूँ। आपने 2021 में कंपनी भविष्य की अच्छा होगा, मैं भी अच्छा करता हूँ 2021 हमारे कंपनी के लिए अच्छा होगा। ऐसे भी आप लोग मारवाड़ी 21 का जो फिगर तो शुभ होता है 2021 जो है ये शुभ रहेगा कि शुभ होता है 11-21। तो धन्यवाद सर, नमस्कार अनिल जी सर आपको बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद है समय देने के लिए, जय हिंद जय भारत। एक बार तो मुझे तकलीफ हुई सर, आपने जब प्रश्न को उत्तर देने लगे ना तो शायद हमें मौका नहीं मिलेगा अपनी भावना प्रकट नहीं करने पड़ेगा, लेकिन माता जी का धन्यवाद दो, उन्होंने आपसे रिक्वेस्ट की और आपने प्रतिबंध दिया, बहुत अच्छा लगा सर। बाकी प्रश्न उत्तर आपने दिए मैं सेटिस्फाई हूँ, धन्यवाद सर, नमस्कार सर। नमस्कार सर, स्वस्थ रहिएगा आशा करता हूँ।
आप भी बोलिए सर, आप स्वस्थ रहिए, आपकी शुभकामनाएं मिली और बिल्कुल मैं आपकी शुभकामनाएं आपके सोच को प्रणाम करता हूं और ईश्वर से प्रार्थना करता हूं कि जेपी इंफ्राटेक जो भी जिसने जो काम किया है वो हमेशा रहने वाला है इस देश के इतिहास में और इंस्पायर करेगा, और आप जैसे लोग हर तरीके से इस सपोर्टर भी हैं, और आपके शब्दों के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, नमस्कार। स्मॉल जो आपने कहा स्मॉल शेयर होल्डर्स का सराफ साहब पूछा आपने, तो एक्चुअली जो प्लान बनाया है एनबीसीसी ने उसके हिसाब से 1 करोड़ रुपए रखे हैं 54 करोड़
शेयर्स
के लिए, तो वही है कि मतलब उस रेशो में एक तरीके से उसको जीरो करने का जो होता है वही मामला है, कम शब्दों में तो बात यही है।
एक और
मिस्टर चेतन चड्डा सर, कैन यू प्लीज कनेक्ट टू मिस्टर चेतन चड्डा।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर।
हाँ जी,
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर मेरी अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑन दिस क्वार्टर। मनोज गौर जी और अनुज जैन जी सर, मैं आपका इस एओवीएम की फर्स्ट एजीएम पे स्वागत करता हूँ और सेक्रेटरियल डिपार्टमेंट का धन्यवाद करना चाहता हूँ जिन्होंने मुझे इस एओवीएम पोर्टल पर आपके साथ जुड़े रहने का मौका दिया। गौर साहब, मैं आपकी एजीएम हर साल जब से हमने आईपीओ अलॉट किया है तब से हर साल आपकी एजीएम अटेंड करने आपके वेन्यू पर नोएडा में आते हैं सेक्टर 128 पे, और आपसे हर साल मुलाकात करने का हमें मौका मिलता है, लेकिन इस साल पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन के कारण हम लोग आपसे व्यक्तिगत रूप से नहीं मिल पा रहे, इसका मुझे काफी अफसोस था, लेकिन सेक्रेटरियल डिपार्टमेंट ने जो मुझे आप लोगों से जुड़ने का मौका दिया उसके लिए मैं उनका भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ और आप लोगों का भी धन्यवाद करता हूँ जिन्होंने मुझे इस मौके पर आप लोगों के साथ दर्शन करने का मौका दिया और जुड़ने का मौका दिया। थोड़ी सी कठिनाइयां थी इस एओवीएम पोर्टल पर जुड़ने के लिए, जिसके लिए सेक्रेटेरियल मिस्टर माटा जी ने मुझे पर्सनली थोड़ा सा गाइड किया और आप लोगों के साथ जुड़ने के लिए मौका दिया, और आज अनफॉर्चुनेटली हमारे यहाँ लाइट भी नहीं आ रही थी, लेकिन उसके बावजूद भी थोड़ी नेट की मैंने अपने पड़ोसी से प्रोबेबिलिटी लेके बाहर खड़े होकर अपने घर के एजीएम कर रहा हूँ, और आप लोग देख पा रहे होंगे कि मैं घर के बाहर खड़ा हूँ क्योंकि थोड़ी नेट की प्रोबेबिलिटी की प्रॉब्लम है, उसके बावजूद भी मैं आपसे जुड़ा हुआ हूँ, इसकी मुझे काफी खुशी है। दूसरी बात सर, मैं चाहता हूँ कि मैं एनबीसीसी सेक्टर से रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहता हूँ कि कोशिश ये करे कि स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर को जिस तरीके से भी बचाया जा सकता है उसे बचाने के लिए अनुज जैन जी हैं और हम लोगों के लिए किस तरीके से कार्यरत हो सकते हैं, हम स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर हैं और आई थिंक कि आप लोग भी जानते हैं कि गौर साहब ने जो हमारे को फाउंडर हैं उन्होंने हमेशा से ये कोशिश की है कि स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर को अच्छी रिटर्न मिले, लेकिन बट इस जो गवर्नमेंट के आने की वजह से इस बार तीन तीन जो हमें मुश्किलों का सामना करना पड़ा है, पहली बात तो जो जीएसटी आ गया, उसके बाद जो है इस 2000 उसमें फिर हमारे को नोटबंदी का भी सामना करना पड़ गया, और उसके बाद अब ये कोरोना की महामारी भी आ गई है। तो हम काफी इससे उभर के बाहर आ पाते, हम उस दलदल के अंदर घसते चले गए और हम किसी और पोजीशन पे पहुंच गए। अब मगर आने वाले समय में मैं आशा करता हूं कि जो हमारा स्टाफ है, ये जो भी हमारे से जुड़ा हुआ है, वो धीरे धीरे इस स्थिति से बाहर आने की तैयारी पर है। तो थोड़ा सा एनबीसीसी को भी सोचना चाहिए कि वो किस तरीके से स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर को बचा सकता है। अमाउंट अभी ना देकर वो अगर अभी प्रोस्पेक्टिवली हम लोगों को सपोर्ट दे और हमारे साथ जुड़ के आपको भी आगे गतिविधि की तरह बढ़ाए और बढ़ावा दे हम लोगों को, ताकि जो स्मॉल इन्वेस्टर है उसकी पूंजी जो है वो क्षतिग्रस्त ना हो, तो थोड़ा सा उनको हमारे लोगों के बारे में ये सोचना चाहिए कि किस तरीके से हम लोगों ने आपके साथ अपनी मेहनत की पूंजी इकट्ठी करके लगाई हुई है, और हम आपके साथ आने वाले समय में अभी सब्र कर सकते हैं और भी, और एक जल्दी डिसीजन कोई भी लेना शायद उचित नहीं रहेगा, क्योंकि वो स्थिति जो है मेरे ख्याल से अभी ऐसी नहीं है। तो कोशिश करके जो नॉर्म्स हैं वो अनुज जैन जी भी अच्छे जानते हैं कि जो सुधार है वो समय लेता है, जो स्थिति बिगड़ गई है अनुकूलित, उसे सुधरने का एक मौका दिया जाए, और मैनेजमेंट को बोर्ड पर बना रहने देने का भी मौका दिया जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि परिस्थितियां समान हमेशा नहीं रहती हैं, समय के अनुसार बदलती रहती हैं। और मैं आशा करता हूं कि आने वाला 2021 हमारे लिए तरक्की लेकर आएगा, और जो स्थितियां उनमें धीरे धीरे सुधार भी आएगा, और हम सभी शेयर होल्डर आपके साथ देखिए जुड़े रहना चाहते हैं, और आपको नए साल की और सभी बोर्ड को मैं नए साल की बहुत बहुत नव वर्ष की बधाई देता हूं, और ये कामना करता हूं कि आने वाले समय में आप लोग हमारे साथ इसी तरह जुड़े रहें और हमें भी अपने साथ मिलने का मौका दें। अगर हम आने वाले समय में एजीएम को वापस उसी फिजिकल मोड में भी करेंगे और साथ साथ इस माध्यम को भी छोड़ेंगे तो मुझे बहुत खुशी होगी सर। धन्यवाद गौर साहब, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सो मच,
थैंक यू सो मच, नमस्कार। सो आई विल लाइक टू नाउ कम टू द कंक्लूडिंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस एजीएम, एंड इन केस देयर आर स्टिल सर्टेन अदर पीपल हु हैव सम क्वेश्चंस, इफ यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू प्लीज फील फ्री टू रीच आउट टू कंपनी सेक्रेटरी and we will address same through email. At this juncture, we will get to God, I on my behalf, on behalf of my colleagues on the board, as well as my respectful thanks to Shri Anuj ji. I would like to present record our gratitude to all the members for spending their valuable time and for participation in the meeting. Please note, e-voting will remain open for another 15 minutes. After the conclusion of these proceedings, and you may kindly vote by that time. The scrutinizer will give the consolidated results of the remote e-voting and e-voting at AGM, which will be declared immediately thereafter, and the same will be hosted on the website of company, stock exchanges, and CDSL, and shall be displayed on the notice board of company within 48 hours of the meeting. And with this, I hereby declare the meeting as concluded. Thank you very much. Namaskar.